Good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday, 31st July, and I'm here to read you the top stories of the day. The Indian government's efforts to extradite Vijay Mallya enters a crucial phase today, as the two sides present final submissions in the long-running extradition case. The case was initially set to continue in mid-July, but was further delayed after a hearing in late April. A ruling is expected later this year, though this will be appealable. The extradition hearing kicked off last December and has focused largely on a series of loans from IDBI Bank to Kingfisher Airlines, from the way in which these were obtained to how, in the words of the prosecution, Mr. Mallya allegedly sought to squirrel away the money. Mr. Mallya stands accused of defrauding the consortium of public sector banks and money laundering, though during the hearings the prosecution focused mostly on the issue of fraud. Defence Barrister Claire Montgomery challenged the prosecution's contention that there was a prima facie case against Mr. Mallya, suggesting that it was a case of business failure rather than fraud. She also sought to portray the case against him as politically motivated, with a heated exchange at one point over the neutrality of the CBI and the decision-making processes of the Supreme Court. A defense witness also raised concerns over the conditions likely to be faced in India by Mr. Mallya in Arthur Road Jail, despite government assurances guaranteeing specific conditions at Barrack 12 of the jail. The health condition of DMK Chief M. Karunanidhi continued to remain stable on Monday after his recovery from a temporary setback on Sunday. Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Edappadi K. Palaniswamy and his deputy O. Paneerselvam visited the hospital to inquire about his health with Mr. Stalin and MP Kanimuri on Monday. They were accompanied by several senior ministers. Isha Yoga founder Jaggi Vasudev also met Mr. Stalin, Ms. Kanimuri and DMK leader Duraimurugan. Film personalities Surya, his father R. Sivakumar, Pandyarajan, Manu Bala and Ramesh Khanna were among others who inquired about his health at the hospital. After a massive Supreme Court monitored exercise to identify illegal migrants living in Assam, the Registrar General of India, or RGI, on Monday found 40 lakh people ineligible to be included in the National Register of Citizens, or NRC. Registrar General of India, Sailesh, said, "This is a draft. We will wait for the final one. Till then, there will be status quo on the rights and privileges of those not included in the NRC." The RGI has given one more chance to those who couldn't make it to the NRC to prove their citizenship. They will have to file claims between August 30th and September 28th. According to the RGI notification, the NRC enumeration process will be completed by December 21st, giving only 5 months to settle the claim of 40 lakh applicants. 83 out of the 541 athletes who will be representing the country at the Asian Games will have to spend from their own pocket to wear Indian colours. This is because the Indian Olympic Association, or IOA, has decided to sponsor kits for only those federations which are affiliated to them. Consequently, the 46 men and 37 women athletes from 8 sports whose federations are not recognized by the IOA will have to foot the bills for their opening and closing ceremony attires, competition kits, training gear and medal ceremony costume. The 8 sports in question are bridge, sports climbing, soft tennis, sepak takraw, sambo, roller skating, penchak silat and Kurash. These unaffiliated members requested the IOA to reconsider their decision during a meeting in Delhi on Saturday. "They're discriminating against us. Eventually, all athletes are representing the country," a federation official told reporters. "We have requested the IOA to reconsider their decision because the expenses are huge." Ethical hackers on Sunday claimed to have the bank account details of Telecom Regulatory Authority of India Chairman R.S. Sharma and posted the same on Twitter. Users also posted screenshots of sending 1 rupee to Sharma via the Aadhaar-enabled payment service using apps like BHIM and Paytm and through IMPS. They also posted the transaction IDs. This is a fallout of the chairman's move to post his Aadhaar number on Saturday and challenging Aadhaar critics to do him harm if they could. On Sunday, ethical hackers pointed out that nearly 14 items had been leaked so far. These include Sharma's mobile numbers, residential address, date of birth, PAN number, voter ID number, telecom operator, phone model, and Air India frequent flyer ID. They also claimed to have his bank account number and IFSC code for 5 other accounts. Anirvar Arvind and a few others sent 1 rupee to his Bank of India account via AEPS. Twitter users cautioned the chairman that the ability to send money to him without his consent could expose him to blackmail, money laundering, and other dangers. We round up this morning with fuel prices for the day. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 76.27 rupees per litre and diesel for 67.83 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 79.22 rupees per litre and diesel for 71.63 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 83.71 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.01 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 79.14 rupees per litre and diesel for 70.52 rupees per litre.